to start my talk. The topic is color intolerance of the preferred skin color. I will start with a brief introduction of the skin color modeling that is used for this study. And the second one is a skin color adjustment method. And this method is used to produce all samples. And third is a psychophysical experiment. And the last is the conclusion. For skin color modeling, we collected about 2,500 images captured using different cameras and under different conditions. And a tool was developed to mask skin colors that I added to a skin color database for skin color studies. And this shows the skin color cluster of our skin color database. They are viewed from different, two different view angles. The shape of the cluster looks like ellipsoid. For the reason, we use an elliptical model to model skin colors for skin color detection. And this shows an example of the skin color detection. The right, left image, this is our source original image. And we have three slightly different models. And the detective pixels are shown in pink. And in this skin color region, within this region, there is a smaller area where skin colors are more preferred to our eyes. So our skin color enhancement method is to morph skin colors toward this region so that we have this skin detection model. We also have a method to adjust the skin colors. So what we are wishing is the determination of this preferred skin color region. So for this purpose, we conducted a series of psychophysical experiments to find this region, to verify this region, and also to verify our skin color enhancement method. And we also performed a few experiments to validate the entire imaging workflow and for system tuning. But for today, I'm only going to talk about our first experiment. And because we don't know where the preferred skin color region is within this entire skin color area, so we uniformly sample the entire skin color region into nine small regions. And for each test image, their skin colors are morphed toward each of these nine centers to produce nine versions of images. And for these nine images, their skin colors are slightly different. And we ask observers to rate their preference of each image. And based on the preference score, we will be able to find our preferred skin color region. We use 12 images, covers light, medium, and dark skin colors, and they include Caucasian, Oriental, and African images. We use an LCD display to display images. The display is characterized to have a D65 white point, 2.2 gamma, and in dim surround condition. We use pair comparison, and have 19 observers to judge images. So this is the experimental result. The higher the score means a stronger preference. And it's very clear that the center 4 and center 7 have a stronger preference. And centers 0, 2, and 1 have a less preference. So based on the Z-score, and in our initial study, we use the color of these 9 skin centers and their corresponding Z-scores to analyze skin color preference. And to find out preferred skin color region for mixed skin tones, we average Z-scores of all 12 images in each skin center. And it's very clear the center 4 and 7 have strong preference. So it's very clear the preferred region is around here, 4 and 7. And to study the potential light risk dependency, we categorize 12 images into 3 groups. Light, medium, and dark toned. And the Z-scores are averaged separately for each group. And it's, here it shows that light and medium group, they have a similar preference, but for dark skin tone has a different preference. And the right image shows that preferred skin color ellipse of these 3 groups. It shows that light and medium skin groups have similar preference, while the dark skin tone group prefer to have a smaller chroma. This plot shows preferred skin color ellipse of all 12 images separately. And one particular image over here, this one, corresponds to this image, has a distinct preferred hue angle, and all others are very consistent. And we closely check this image and find out it has a green cast. So observers find those more red skin centers to cancel off green cast. So it seems our analysis has a problem. It becomes image dependent. If we choose image, let's say if it's in red direction, then the preferred skin center will be in the yellow region. So this is not right. So the first problem is that we use the colors of these 9 skin centers and their corresponding Z-scores to analyze preference. And we completely ignore the skin color distribution of original image. So it looks like a right way to do is to use a representative skin color from each adjusted image and their corresponding Z-scores to analyze preference. To do that, we make a skin mask for each of these 12 test images. And for each image, we have 9 versions of adjusted image. So we compute a representative skin color for each version. And one way to do it is to compute mean skin color from all skin colors based on the mask. And another method is to use a critical spots to compute a mean skin color to represent that version of adjusted image. And then we use their corresponding Z-scores to analyze color preference. So now this is the new result. And now we don't see the image that was shifted to the reddish region. Now it's moved to the center. And the preference is quite consistent in hue angle. And also another thing that we don't see is that the distribution of the preference among these three groups, they are not much different, not as much different as before. And we also categorize these set of images into Caucasian, Oriental, and African images. And the reason we took out three other images is that because it's difficult to put those three images into any of these three groups. And this result will be shown in a little slide in a plot. And this plot shows the variation. For each image, we have 19 preferred skin colors from 19 observers. So we get a variation point, variation colors, and then generate a variation ellipse for each image. And in overall, all of these ellipses, most of ellipses are very consistent in size, shape, and orientation. That means they have a very little image dependence. And for this plot, we put all of those preferred skin colors from 19 observers by 12 images. So it's slightly more than 200 points. We use those points to generate this preferred skin color ellipse. And it's clear the hue variation is smaller than chroma variation. And also from look at this sign 9, this is the major axis of the ellipse. It shows a very interesting behavior. If an observer prefers more chroma, higher chroma skin colors than average preference, then the preferred hue angle tends to be slightly higher, which means slightly more yellowish. And if an observer prefers less chromatic skin colors than average preference, then the hue preference is, tends to be slightly smaller, which means the hue preference for lower skin chroma is slightly more reddish. And this plot shows is to compare our preferred skin color region to the real skin color region, and also compare to the preferred skin colors from other studies. The real skin colors are computed from IIT and ORU spectral skin color database. And over here, all of these orange dots are Caucasian skin colors. And the black dots are African skin colors. The pink dots are from Oriental skin colors. And over here it shows very clear that preferred skin colors are more chromatic than real skin colors. And next, preferred Caucasian skin color is very slightly more yellowish than real Caucasian skin colors. And preferred African and Oriental skin colors are more reddish than they are real skin colors. And we already showed this plot. This is drawn in C-Lab A star B star coordinates. And all variation ellipses are very thin and long. We redraw it in the C-CAM O2 uniform color space. And this ellipses turns out to be slightly more circular. And also their eccentricity are closer to unity, which means seems to imply that C-CAM O2 uniform color space is slightly more uniform than C-Lab in this particular skin color region. So this is the conclusion. prefer skin colors are more chromatic than real skin colors. And prefer skin colors have a smaller tolerance and hue than in chroma. Prefer skin color is about 49 degrees in C depth and adapted to the 50 illuminant. Prefer Caucasian skin colors is slightly more yellowish than real Caucasian skin colors. And prefer African and Oriental skin colors are slightly more reddish than their real skin colors. And C came out to uniform color space is slightly more uniform than C lab in skin color region. Thank you.
Okay, we have a question in the back.
Thank you, that was a very interesting paper. I have a question about your observers though. Did you also choose the observers to actually correspond to your skin color class? And did you analyze if there would be a difference? So a Caucasian looking at Caucasian versus Asian and African skin plus the other kind of groups?
No, in this is the first phase of our experiment. We use a single group of observer. They are a mix of Caucasian, Asian, and African. So this preference is meant to be a cross-cultural preference.
But you could analyze it by group, because I think that might be interesting how people kind of perceive their own race versus a different kind of race.
Yes, we conducted different experiments for this analysis. But for this particular experiment, because we have only 19 observers, if we divided it into three groups, then the observers are observers.